So I spent a good part of yesterday at the Google Pixel 2 event, and whilst my throat is literally dying from 4 hours of trying to shout over a DJ, we came away with some very interesting points regarding the phone. First up is the camera, and whilst on paper this seems like a pretty ordinary device, it's got a 12.3 megapixel sensor and an f1.8 aperture, it is the software that makes this really special. First of all, in terms of video, it shoots 4K video at 30 frames per second, which is again pretty standard, but instead of using optical image stabilization or electronic image stabilization, the phone uses both. And long story short, that just means your footage is even steadier. But it gets better, because one of the huge surprises at yesterday's event was the fact that the phone can take portrait mode photos. Now for those of you who don't know, portrait mode effectively allows the background of your image to be blurred. But in the past, and to be honest with every competing smartphone, the way they go about doing this is completely different. Whilst each of those phones needs a dual camera to implement this tech, the Google Pixel manages to do it with just a single one. And the implications are massive. It means that not only can the company afford to have a better quality sensor on the rear of the phone because they've only got one to worry about, it also implies that it works on the front camera. So yes, you can now, with the Google Pixel 2 and Pixel 2 XL, take portrait mode photos with the front camera, which for most people is going to be completely game-changing. Also, for the real techies among you, this smartphone scores 98 points in DxOMark, which is essentially the universal benchmarking tool used to see how good a smartphone camera is. And essentially, if you compare that to previous generations of the smartphone, this is a quantum leap in terms of performance. So then we've got battery, and with a 3,520 mAh battery on the Pixel 2 XL, we are promised a day's battery life with about 30% to spare. And don't forget, as well as having a pretty large capacity battery, it also has the latest version of pure Android and basically no bloatware. Now, for me, one of the very best things about this smartphone are the dual front-facing stereo speakers. The fact of the matter is, most current phones with their terrible audio quality have almost forced me to start using earphones, but this one is reversing that trend and I like it. The speakers are loud. I was actually testing the smartphone next to my Galaxy Note 8, and whilst the Galaxy Note 8 was completely overshadowed by the DJ set going on in the same room, you could hear every word of the audio from the Pixel 2 XL. Not only that, but the sound is fuller, it's richer, it's got a better potential to reach the lower notes, and that gives a certain fullness to voices, which sounds much more natural to listen to. And of course, because these are stereo speakers positioned on either side of the display, you've got this extra level of immersion. The sound you hear from the phone has a level of direction to it. So now for something completely different, we've got Google Lens, which essentially adds a whole new level of intelligence to the smartphone's camera. It allows the phone to understand the objects within the image, which sounds like a marketing term, it kind of sounds a little bit gimmicky, but wait till you see what it can do. For example, you could grab your Pixel and take a photo off the back of your home's router. It would then be able to understand from that what the router's name was and what the password was to get in, and automatically connect your smartphone to the internet. On top of that, you could take a photo of a business card, and it would be able to identify the email address, the telephone number, and automatically be able to save them to your contacts. It can understand books, films, movies, posters, buildings, landmarks, statues, even plants and animals, and it can also translate in real time. And we can't forget about the new Google Assistant, which can now not only integrate with the Lens functionality, but also make transactions and function with routines. But as well as being smarter, it has been made far easier to access, because as rumored, the Pixel 2 XL comes with a squeeze to action functionality. So just holding the phone in one hand and exerting a little bit more pressure on one of the sides, it'll bring up the Assistant. There's no buttons, there's no faff, and it also means that the pressure sensitivity is completely adjustable. It works in a similar way to 3D Touch, there's nothing actually squeezing in necessarily, it's more just like a vibration motor which makes it feel that way. So guys, I really hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope you're as excited for this smartphone as I am. Hopefully we'll be getting a review sample in pretty early, so we'll be able to make some really cool coverage of the device. Thanks a lot for watching guys, I'm Mr. Who's the Boss, and I'll catch you in the next one.